So today I'm going to be showing you guys how to do the seamless join on this cute little bunny rabbit pattern I just made. As you can see, the stitches just continue up from the legs to the body relatively seamlessly. Unlike what you get here with the arm, you can see that little seam where you attached the separate piece of crochet to the body. So that's what I'm going to be teaching you to do today. And if you're interested in this pattern, it's for sale in my Etsy shop. So we have our two little example legs here. We have leg one in this hand and leg two over here. They're both 12 stitches around. This one has been slip stitched and finished off. And for leg two, you are told do not slip stitch and finish off. And that's so we can connect them. So I'm going to chain one, and if I were to count my stitches right now, I'd have 13 stitches on my hook. And I'm gonna pick up this other leg, get a better grip on my yarn, and I'm going to start out by crocheting into the first stitch. I like to go right next to the knot, but in the end, it doesn't really matter. So I'm just going to single crochet directly into that leg. And now, if I were to count all the stitches on my hook, I would have 25. 12 from this leg, 12 from this leg, for a total of 24. With this chain, I'd now have 25. So I'm going to continue crocheting around this leg until I get to this stitch right here, this last stitch before this chain connect. Okay, so now I've gotten all the way around to the beginning. I still have 25 stitches on my hook, but what I do now is chain one, so that's 26 stitches, and I'm going to connect back to this leg. Be sure not to connect in the same stitch that you put your chain in. Be sure to go one over from there, and then just single crochet like you did with the other leg, all the way around until you get to the first chain on this side that you put in. So I'll meet you back when you've gotten there. Excellent. So now I've finished crocheting around this leg and I find myself at this chain stitch, and you're going to continue along with the pattern, building your body upwards. And what you'll see is that you do have a gap between your legs. And what I do is crochet a couple rounds up the body, follow the pattern, do whatever you're doing, and then come back and with the tail of leg one here, just weave this together. Just connect it, weave it together, and close up that hole so you can stuff your piece. And that's the basics. All you need to do is keep crocheting around and around, and you'll have a body.